So Khadijah radiallahu ta'ala anha, she had everything. She had wealth, she had beauty, she came from a noble family. Not only she was the wealthiest, she was the most noble and the most beautiful woman in Makkah al-Mukarramah. And for that reason, she received proposals from many people. But Khadijah radiallahu ta'ala anha, she was waiting for something to happen. And this is often not told. Remember, eventually when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam received revelation, who did Khadijah take him to? To a cousin. What was the cousin's name? Waraqa ibn Nawfal. Tamam. So, Nawfal was Khadijah's father, Khuwaylid's brother. So Waraqa was a cousin. But of course a much older cousin, because he was much older than Khadijah. And because he was much older, and he also had access to divine scriptures of the past, he was a religious man. And Khadijah came from a religious family. Khadijah used to spend a lot of time with Waraqa, learning from him things that happened in previous religions about Nabi Ibrahim and Nabi Musa and Nabi Isa. Right? She used to listen to all of these. And then Khadijah had a dream. Right? As a young girl, she had a dream. And in this dream, she saw the sun setting in her home. She saw the sun setting in her home. So when she woke up from this dream, she went to her cousin Waraqa. And she said that, "I had this dream. Can you interpret the dream for me? And then he interpreted the dream of Khadijah, and he said to her that you will get married to the final prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Khadijah got married to Abu Halahin, and she got married to Atiq. But Khadijah in her heart was waiting for what? She was waiting to get married to the final prophet of the time. That seed was planted in her heart when she was a young girl because of a dream. Right? And when people come to propose, she doesn't see qualities of a prophet in them. So she doesn't bother accepting their proposals. Otherwise, why would she reject the proposal of so many good young suitors? Until eventually, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is in Makkah al-Mukarramah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is growing up, and he comes from a noble family. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam is known for his trustworthiness. The most outstanding quality that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was known for was his truthfulness and his trustworthiness. So Khadijah already in her mind thought that this is a young man that we should be looking out for. And the wasila, or the medium through which she's going to come to know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam better, is she runs a business. And when she runs a business, she needs men to run the business for her. So she hired the services of men. They would come and take her goods, transport it all the way to Busra in Greater Syria, and they would sell the goods for her, purchase goods for her, bring it back, and Khadijah would pay them accordingly. Or they would earn profit, or whatever the arrangement was. But she would hire the services of young men. And when Khadijah heard of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of course, in her heart she desired to hire the services of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. On the one hand, he's trustworthy and reliable, and he's truthful. But on the other hand, she's already seeing amazing qualities in this young man, and perhaps he is the final prophet of our time. At the same time, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's uncle Abu Talib. Everyone knows Abu Talib, right? He was the father of Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala. Abu Talib suggests to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Why don't you go into business?" Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a shepherd now for most of his life. The next phase was, "Why don't you go into business?" Because the Prophet has become 25 years of age. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam also needs to get married. But he lost his father, he was born an orphan, his mother died, his grandfather died, he's living with Abu Talib. Abu Talib has so many kids in his home, Abu Talib cannot really take full care of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the extent that create work for him and then find a job for him and eventually allow him to get married. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Talib suggests to Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Khadijah is hiring men, why don't you consider working for her?" When Khadijah come to learn that Abu Talib suggested that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam works for her, immediately she took advantage of the opportunity and she approached the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that we know that you are a man of trustworthiness and that you are truthful. Take this caravan for us to Busra in Syria, sell the goods, purchase goods, come back home and we will give you double that what we give any other male. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam accepted. And she sends with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam her young slave boy by the name of Maysara, and she says to Maysara that I need you to observe this man. Right? And Imam Shafi and others say the best way you come to know somebody is three things: living with them, traveling with them, and doing business. So Maysara was living with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was traveling with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he witnessed the business ethic of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the journey begins. And in this journey, Maysara now witnesses amazing things. Things that cannot be explained. One of the things he witnesses, as it comes in the Sahih, that wherever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam walks, there is a cloud giving him shade. Wherever he goes, there's a cloud giving him shade, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He's not yet a prophet. That's inaya rabbaniya, divine care. Other narration said it was not clouds giving him shade, but angels giving him shade. The Prophet ﷺ in this journey came across another monk, not Buhayra. When he was a young boy with his uncle Abu Talib, they came across Buhayra. And Buhayra told the Prophet ﷺ's uncle Abu Talib that that young boy with you is the final prophet of our time. Don't take him with the Syria, send him back home. And Abu Talib sent him back home. Right? Then, on this journey, the Prophet ﷺ was traveling now with Maysara. They came across another monk whose name slips my mind. I think it was something like Nastur. And this monk spoke to Maysara because the Prophet ﷺ took rest under a tree. And this monk came to Maysara and told him, only prophets have rested under that tree. And then another interaction in Busra, in Syria itself, a businessman that was from the people of the book, he also indicated to Maysara that based on the dealings of this man, he seems to be the final prophet of our time. Three instances. And then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he had great business skill. He sold the goods of Khadijah. After selling the goods of Khadijah, he purchased goods, but he sold at a good price. And yet he sold at a high price, at a good price. He purchased goods for a very low price, and this allowed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to sell the same goods on the same market for a second time, and then to purchase goods again for a second time. So by the time the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam reached back to Mecca, he profited such an amount that no one ever profited before. And when Khadijah heard that, she was very happy. But right now, Khadijah is not too worried about how much profit the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is making. She's waiting to speak with Maysara. Maysara, what can you tell me about this man? So Maysara relates to her and says to her that wherever he walked, there were clouds following him. We met the monk, Nastur, and he said that's the final prophet of our time, as well as the businessman that we met in Busra of Syria. So Khadija, it's as if her mind was made up. Besides that, Maysara said that even though I was the servant of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was so kind to me, he was so beautiful, he was so supporting, that many a times it felt as if he was the slave and I was the master. Right? He was, Maysara, not only these miracles he related that his speech was beautiful, the way he interacted was beautiful, the way he supported and assisted, so much so that I felt as if I was the master and he was the slave. So Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, when she heard this news from Maysara, that was like the final stamp on her heart, that this has to be my husband, right? This has to be my husband. So she speaks to a friend of her by the name of Nafisa, and she relays these feelings over to Nafisa, to which Nafisa says that, I will go and speak to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on your behalf. So Nafisa goes and she says, O Muhammad bin Abdullah, Khadija bint Khuwaylid has expressed her interest in getting in marriage, in having you as a husband.